How are you feeling right now?
I feel pretty good. You know, my energy kind of comes and goes.
He's a little thinner, walks a little slower, but Wake Forest baseball coach Tom Walter says donating a kidney to an ailing player isn't the toughest thing he's ever had to do.
Which is easier, recovering from a hurricane or recovering from a kidney transplant?
Oh, recovering from a kidney transplant, without question.
Almost 6 years before making headlines, going above and beyond for one of his players, Walter had to fight for his entire team at the University of New Orleans after Hurricane Katrina.
We were trying to search for people that we knew.
You didn't even know if everybody was alive.
Yeah, the phones definitely, you couldn't call anybody. No.
These former players tell me when their lives were turned upside down, Walter was the one who gave them hope.
You don't know what's going on, you don't know what's going to happen. He was there saying, no, we're going to play.
And it's not like Coach Walter didn't have his own problems. After Katrina, his house was flooded and he lost almost everything. It would have been so easy for him to say, that's it, the season's over. Why didn't you?
The players, you know, out of respect and loyalty to the players. It never occurred to me to give up on those guys.
So with nowhere to live, nowhere to practice, he took the New Orleans team to New Mexico for the semester. Then, for months after, he lived in a trailer on campus, working constantly to keep his team playing and his program together. No one who knew him then was surprised to hear about him donating a kidney to a player. And less than 2 weeks after the operation, he was on the field for his team's season opener and a standing ovation before the game. Admiration for a coach who shows everyone what it takes to be a winner. David Mattingly, CNN, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.